Hi friends, my name is Phanindra Gupta. So in this video, let us discuss about structural pathway of glycolysis. And in this video, I'm going to explain to you about structural pathway of glycolysis. But in previous video, I explained to you about normal pathway of glycolysis, which doesn't consist of any structures. So this is a little complicated. And that video which I explained previously is just for lower classes. And this structural pathway of glycolysis, which includes structures, is meant only for higher classes. So now let us discuss about the structural pathway of glycolysis, which includes structure. So we know that, and one more thing, the introduction and each and everything of this glycolysis I have given in the previous video itself, and the link of that video will be given in the description box. So people who are interested, you can watch that. So if it's better first if you watch that, then only you can understand this properly. Okay, so firstly, let us discuss about this glycolysis pathway with structures. So coming to the glycolysis pathway, starts with glucose, right? So here glucose, this is the cyclic structure of glucose, and cyclic structure is normally formed from the normal structure itself. And this formation of this, how this structure has been formed, cyclic structure has been formed, and what is the reason behind it, I explained in my previous video in carbohydrates. And this glucose comes under the classification of carbohydrates, and explained the structures, how the formation of this cyclic structure takes place, and the link of that video will be given in the description box. So please watch that video. So coming to here, glucose, this is the cyclic structure of glucose. So we know that there will be totally 6 carbons in the glucose, and each of the carbon consists of its appropriate hydroxyl group, OH group, alcohol group, and aldehyde group. So coming to here, this will be the structure of glucose, cyclic structure of glucose. So here glucose will get converted to glucose 6 phosphate, and during the conversion of this glucose to glucose 6 phosphate, ATP will be utilized and ADP will get reduced. Okay, so here glucose 6 phosphate. So what is the main difference between glucose and glucose 6 phosphate? And here glucose at the at the 6th carbon, here there is a presence of OH group, but here at the 6th carbon there is a presence of P, phosphate group. This indicates phosphate group. So glucose 6 phosphate, at the 6th carbon there is a presence of phosphate group, so we have to mention here P in such a way that we can understand that it is a, there is a presence of phosphate group at the 6th carbon in the glucose. And normally if you count a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this will be acts as 5th carbon, but as it formed as a cyclic structure, we should consider this as 6th carbon. And why it should be considered as 6th carbon, I explained in the previous video itself. So it's better if you watch that video, then you can understand the cyclic structure of glucose, and not only the glucose, even fructose also. Okay, so coming to the next, glucose 6 phosphate will get converted to fructose 6 phosphate by utilizing an enzyme known as hexophosphate isomerase. Writing enzymes are very much important. Hexophosphate isomerase, fructose 6 phosphate, this will be the structure of fructose 6 phosphate. And normally cyclic structure of fructose consists of OH group at the 1st carbon and OH group at the 6th carbon also, but here in this name itself indicates that 6 phosphate, that's nothing but at the 6th carbon there is a presence of phosphate group. So at the 6th carbon, this is the 6th carbon, there is a presence of phosphate group. So writing P indicates that there is a presence of phosphate group at the 6th carbon of the fructose, and here 6th carbon at the presence of glucose. Okay, and this fructose 6 phosphate will get converted to fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. So here you have to understand, see here, normally this is a structure of fructose 6 phosphate, but here fructose 1,6 phosphate, by the name itself you can understand that the first carbon and the second and the sixth carbon undergoes transformations. That's nothing but you have to write phosphate group at the first carbon also, 1,6, one first carbon and sixth carbon, we have to add phosphate groups. So bisphosphate, why I have written bisphosphate, because 2, 1, 2 by bisphosphate. So if there is a presence of 1,3,6 triphosphate, okay, 1,2,3,6 tetraphosphate, in that way you have to write according to this name. Okay, so here ATP will get utilized and ADP gets reduced, okay, during the transformation of fructose 6 phosphate to fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. The enzyme utilized is phosphofructokinase, and the ATP energy is utilized and ADP gets reduced. So here, by utilizing an enzyme known as triose phosphate isomerase, it gets reduced to DHAP and G3P. DHAP is nothing but dihydroxyacetone phosphate, and G3P means glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So now let us see the structures. So this is dihydroxyacetone phosphate, DHAP, and G3P, glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So dihydroxyacetone phosphate, dihydroxyacetone, dihydroxy, the two carbons, there is a presence of phosphate group, dihydroxy. This is the first carbon, the second carbon and the third carbon. So at the two carbons, I am taking here first carbon and second carbon, and at the two carbons there is a presence of phosphate group. Hence we name it as a dihydroxy acetone phosphate, okay, phosphate group. Okay, coming to the next, G3P, glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. This will be the structure of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. 3 phosphate is nothing but at the third carbon there is a presence of phosphate group, and if there is a presence of only H, then glyceraldehyde phosphate, it becomes only glyceraldehyde phosphate. Okay, so coming to the next, this glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate undergoes transformations, but this DHAP will not undergo transformation, but it undergoes only one transformation. That is nothing but this DHAP will also get converted to G3P and continues the pathway. Okay, this DHAP which has been remained over here will get converted to G3P and continues the pathway, and G3P which has been remained as it is from the cycle will also get converted. So both of them will get converted as a G3P in such a way that to continue the cycle. So the G3P which has been formed from normal cycle and also from the DHAP undergoes transformation and mainly forms 1,3 bisphosphoglyceric acid by utilizing an enzyme known as G3P dehydrogenase. So G3P dehydrogenase is an enzyme which is mainly utilized for the transformation of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate to 1,3 bisphosphoglyceric acid, and here ADP will utilized and ADP will get reduced. So here if you see glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate is nothing but G3P which I have explained you here, and 1,3 bisphosphoglyceric acid, there's nothing but 1,3 at the first carbon, and at the third carbon there is a presence of phosphate group. 1,3 bisphospho, bisphospho is nothing but 1,3. There are totally two carbons which undergoes transformations, right? So we have to write 1,3 bis. Okay, 1,3 at the first carbon and at the third carbon there is a presence of phosphate group. Okay, so we have mentioned the name 1,3 bisphosphoglyceric acid, and that 1,3 bisphosphoglyceric acid which has been formed will undergo transformation to form 3 phosphoglyceric acid, and the enzyme which has been utilized here is phosphoglycerokinase. So phosphoglycerokinase is the enzyme which helps in this transformation, and here 3 phosphoglyceric acid which has been shortly abbreviated as PGA. PGA means phosphoglyceric acid. 3 PGA, 3 phosphoglyceric acid, and 3 phosphoglyceric acid is nothing but there will be change you can see only at the third carbon. 3 phosphoglyceric acid, 3 at the third carbon there will be the change. So this is the third carbon, at first carbon, second carbon and third carbon there will be the change. Normally this will be the structure of phosphoglyceric acid. This is 1,3 bisphosphoglyceric acid and this 3 phosphoglyceric acid, but here this is the normal structure of phosphoglyceric acid, and if you see here properly there is the presence of COOH, CHOH, CH2OH at the 3 carbon, at the 3 carbons, right? So 1,3 bisphosphoglyceric acid, at the first carbon and third carbon there is a presence of phosphate group. So here H will be removed. We should not say it removed, it gets transformed to phosphate group, because we include here first carbon and third carbon transformations, right? So here 3 phosphoglyceric acid, so we have to write H as it is because we didn't mention first carbon in the name, right? So we have mentioned third carbon in the name, so we have to write 3 phosphate. There's nothing but at the third carbon there will be the presence of phosphate group. So we will write here 3 phosphoglyceric acid. Okay, and this 3 phosphoglyceric acid which has been formed will get converted to 2 phosphoglyceric acid by utilizing an enzyme known as phosphoglyceromutase. Okay, and here 2 phosphoglyceric acid means if you see here COOH, CHOP. So here at the third carbon there will be the presence of phosphate, but the first carbon and this third carbon will remain as it is, but there will be the transformation which takes place at the second carbon, because the name itself indicates that 2 phosphoglyceric acid, the phosphate group will be present at the second carbon in the structure. So if you see here, this is a normal structure, right? So at the second carbon there is the presence of P, but first carbon and third carbon will be remain as it is, same. Okay, so hence it is named as 2 phosphoglyceric acid, and the enzyme utilized here is phosphoglyceromutase. Okay, and next, 2 phosphoglyceric acid which has been formed will get converted to phosphoenolpyruvate by utilizing an enzyme known as enolase. So if you see here, this H which is present at the second carbon and the OH which is present at the third carbon will get combined together and releases water molecule. It gets reduced to water molecule. Okay, so it is 2 phosphoglyceric acid which reduces the water molecule undergoes undergoes transformation and mainly forms phosphoenolpyruvate by utilizing an enzyme known as enolase. And here phosphoenolpyruvate, so COOH, COP, because the H and OH has been removed, so the remaining structure will be remained as it is. that is said to be as phosphoenolpyruvate. And finally, there will be the formation of pyruvic acid from the phosphoenolpyruvate by utilizing an enzyme known as pyruvic kinase. And here the ADP will get utilized and the ATP gets reduced. So finally, here the pyruvic acid which has been formed will be, is 3-carbon compound, because see here, count here, 1, 2, 3, 3-carbon compound, okay. So this is very much important to remember, the pyruvic acid which has been formed as a product in the glycolysis pathway is 3-carbon compound, okay. So the glucose which has been formed over starting here, this is a 6-carbon compound. From the beginning, if you see in the beginning, the glucose which has been formed here is 6-carbon compound, but the product which has been formed here, pyruvic acid, is 3-carbon compound, okay. So it's very important to remember. So thank you for watching this video, guys. If you like this video, please do like and subscribe, and if you have any doubts regarding this video, please comment in the comment box. I will clarify your doubts immediately. 4, 3, 2, 1. Yeah!